There's over 600,000 bridges in the United States which are in continuous use by our transportation network. But 25% of that inventory of bridges is either structurally deficient or functionally obsolete, which means that they're very expensive to maintain, and unfortunately, structural failures can occur within those aging infrastructure systems.
This project is looking at a variety of different sensor technologies. Foremost among the sensor technologies that we're exploring are wireless sensors, which are low-cost sensing alternatives to traditional wired sensors. This allows us to collect information such as strain at multiple locations on a bridge as trucks and cars drive over it.
The activity that I'm leading is the truck-bridge interaction. Actually, what we're doing here is we're figuring out exactly what loads the truck is putting into the bridge as it's driving across. And one of the complications is that you don't need to know just what load the truck has statically, but the truck doesn't ride completely smoothly over the bridge. So there are dynamic loads, and those will excite the bridge in different ways depending on how the truck hits the various bumps on the bridge. So we have a sensor network on the truck, and this sensor network talks to the sensor network on the bridge. If you put it all together, you can see what the overall interaction is. And this is a critical part of the process, because if you don't know what's going into the bridge, it's very hard to see how important it is what the bridge response is.
We're powering these sensors using RF energy that we can collect parasitically from AM radio signals located close to the bridge that we've installed. In addition to wireless sensors, we're also looking at self-sensing materials that are sensing appliques made of carbon nanotube materials through which we can pass electrical currents. The passing of electrical currents allows us to see what kind of damage and deterioration is occurring on the bridge, such as corrosion detection, providing maps to the decision maker that shows clearly where and how severe the corrosion or damage may be. In addition, we're looking at how vehicles load our bridges, and we're installing sensors in our trucks such that we can collect data from that and pass that on to the bridge monitoring system.
We have in excess of 20 sensors that are recording the dynamic loads on the truck, because we can't directly measure the force between the tires of the truck and the bridge surface. So we have to do some analysis to backtrack what those loads are. But we're using sophisticated instrumentation, and we know exactly where the truck is, and we can estimate what the loads are to a high degree of detail.
Once that data is collected by our various sensors on the bridge, they're passed via cellular communication back to the internet, where we have a variety of data storage elements. In particular, we have a data storage element called SenStore, which is a scalable database that allows us to store bridge data as well as sensor data. So once data is stored in SenStore, we're able to use data processing clients that can process that data to extract information for decision makers and pass that on to the decision tool chests. That information can also empower inspectors that are on site doing visual inspections of our bridge structures. That in whole is our bridge health monitoring system developed under this particular project.
While the technology is highly innovative, we want to make sure it's synergistic with existing management methods such as visual inspections. So another thrust area of our project is looking at how can we combine quantitative sensor data with more qualitative type decision making that's done based on visual inspections.
This is a time consuming process and ends up being subjective in many ways, because the exercise mainly involves inspectors going out into the field and using their engineering and professional judgment to rate different bridge components or elements. And these ratings together eventually lead to a combined rating for the bridge. And based on this rating, there are several decisions taken regarding the safety and structural usefulness of the bridge. By being able to interact with the bridge information model database while in the field, the inspectors will have access to previous inspections, notes made during previous inspections, any multimedia captured during previous inspections, and essentially the justification behind what a component or element of the bridge was rated during its previous inspections. And they can then correlate that information to what they observe in the field during that particular time and make a more informed judgment of what the actual condition of the bridge is at that point in time.